jump down in there, Chris, and push it down. If you can.
Oh my gosh. I just picked up a Hikoki battery for our Hikoki finishing guns because we are at the finishing stage and we're using the guns a lot. I'm stopping to get myself a coffee and parked up next to a familiar van. Oh, hi there.
What's up, buddy?
How's it going?
What's going on?
This is the battery I'm used to, the 3-amp Hikoki. And I think this was a 5-amp that I picked up this morning. Bit chunkier, eh, Pato? It's not bad though. That is a welcome improvement. These batteries, as great as they are for being so slim, you can never check how high the percentage is on the battery. So we're doing a lot of the finishing, but these guys are coming today to remove all the insulation in the ceiling. So we're at the finishing touches. A lot of the plastering is getting done. And I started doing the timber finishing here. Door stops and stuff like that. Full width door stops. And then this detail here to match here. So yeah, I do plan on carrying on with that, but first we've got to get these insulation guys set up. So the insulation guys just need two hatches, one each end of the house. And we figured this was a good time to do this because we're plastering and painting. And we're replacing patches in the ceiling. So before we replace this one, we're using it as an outlet. You ready, bro? See, insulation is something I get asked about a lot. I've noticed a lot of you guys are overseas in other countries and you've seen the way we build houses here and commented that it wouldn't hold up where you are. Yeah, it's very different here. It's warmer for one and we don't get below zero. I think it's happened in my life a couple of times. I might be wrong about that, but it gets to like 2 degrees at the coldest Celsius. It's a pretty mild climate and very humid. So under the floor here there's no insulation, but if you look over there there is insulation. As soon as we're finished with everything we'll jump into there and put that insulation in there. Now that's pretty standard to have, I think it's R1.8 or 1.9 or something, insulation in the underfloor to prevent cold air coming through the house. And a thing we try and do on every renovation is a vapor barrier like this. Because literally liters of water rise up from the ground every day, and if you don't have a barrier there, that's moisture getting into your house. Now the ceiling, that's what's happening today. Now the guys here are taking out two things. The original InsuFluff insulation that we had to deal with when we were doing all the ceilings through there, that's scattered throughout the whole house. And whoever put the new insulation on top 10 or so years ago chucked it on top. And they didn't take out the old stuff because taking out the old stuff is a hell of a job. So that's a higher rating. If the bottom is R1.9, this is more like R3 or something. And that's to stop the heat in the room from escaping through the roof. So that's pretty standard in New Zealand to have ceiling insulation and underfloor insulation. In the walls is where a lot of houses in this country do not have insulation.
The only way. Don't get stuck.
So wall insulation is a lot harder to retrofit because you have to rip all the wall lining off or the cladding off. So a lot of houses don't have it in this country. But when we renovate like we are here, we make sure that we add it. In this case, this is an internal wall. So it's not, you know, you have to insulate your external walls. the walls that go out to the outside of the house, but the internal walls you don't have to insulate. We did insulate it in this case for sound. So this is a silencer insulation thing, it's called. That's the bedroom behind that wall, and you and I are standing in the lounge. So we don't want that sound traveling between walls. So the client said, while we're doing all this, why not update the insulation so it's good for another 10 years? That's what's happening. Our business sucks. I get it. So we're just trying to take away all the things that are unnecessary on site before we do all the finishing and finish off the plasterboard. I was thinking about insulation when I knew I was going to talk about it today, and it reminded me of years ago. I worked for a builder who was doing jobs for Housing New Zealand, and basically the idea was we wanted to insulate all external walls of the houses. As I said earlier, it's not as straightforward as the ceiling and the floor. You have to remove the internal lining before you can put the insulation in. So what we had to do was, I couldn't believe this when I turned up the site. What we had to do was, we had to get a reciprocating saw, cut along the top of the skirting, and do the same at the top with the scotia, pop off the plasterboard, chuck all the insulation in, and then get silicon, put it along the top of the skirting and along the scotia and around the window, and then blob in the new plasterboard, the new jib board, and then like screw it off, and that was it. And I was like, what are we doing? You know, why are we doing it like this? And he said, honestly, man, they don't provide enough money for us to do it the proper way. The proper way is to take the skirting off, take the scotia off, plasterboard all the way down to the ground, and then put the finishing timber over the top of that. But we had to do like 3 houses a day in order to make it viable. So I lasted like 3 weeks there. It was so bad. I should mention they didn't do anything about the windows. The windows were single glazed, and they stayed single glazed. So it was all insulated all the way around with a single pane window in the middle. There is another thing to consider if you want to insulate your external walls in New Zealand, and that is you can't just take the plasterboard off and insulate it. You need the council to approve it, so you have to get an architect to design the wall cavity, draw exactly what's going to happen. They have to approve that, and then you can take the wall off, put your paper in, put your insulation in, and then they come and check it. That's a huge barrier for a lot of people. No one wants to spend, you know, a couple of $1,000 to get a consent to put in $1,000 worth of insulation. A lot of customers that I meet don't want to go down that road, but that's the road we have to go down. I get it. In one respect, they have to check that you're not just filling the wall cavity and, you know, potentially creating a situation where you've got insulation and moisture hitting each other, and then that leads to mold. They want to see the paper in correctly. They want to see like a bit of an air gap between the cladding and the paper. And then the insulation goes in. But it's another barrier, right? It's another situation that leads to cold houses in New Zealand. Yeah, that's insulation. I get a lot of questions about it. Pretty good looking floor. Yep. That's a pretty cool invention, huh?
Yeah.
All right, let's struggle.
look at the flooring, not bad, eh?
Yeah, it looks fantastic.
Is it time of day, Potter?
Sure.
We told Todd and Ants about this bakery, and it seems like they're coming from far and wide to eat here now. How's the pies? How are the pies?
Oh, great pies from the Mount Eden Bakery.
Yes.
Not an ad.
Not an
just
ad.
What do you call it? Bloody review.
You paid full price for that pie,
yep.
Right?
Full pay, full price. I got the cheese.
You
all right?
Just a little.
Can you edit that out?
Coming back for seconds, eh?
Oh, it's for Ants.
Oh, nice.
Keep going.
Anything else?
Yeah. The barbecue chicken roll as well, thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, look, it's there.
Hello. Just come to do some business.
Oh, right.
Like a different
business
man with a shower.
I've had a haircut, yeah.
This
yeah.
Businessman.
Where's my pie at?
Pie going there, Jess.
It's nice.
Yeah, you loving it?
But I've just been craving a good peppered steak pie, and it's like no one does them anymore.
Someone needs to get onto it, eh?
If your subscribers know where I can get a good peppered steak pie, write in the comments below.
Thank you, Jess. Very cool.
Like and subscribe.
So how come you haven't been in the videos, Rich? What's going on?
I've been away.
Yeah?
I've left you guys.
You've left us in the lurch?
Yeah. I'm demolishing a garage.
Your own garage?
Garage.
Garage.
French.
Well, I appreciate you filling in while I was away, Rich. It's very helpful.
I brought your battery back, Scott.
Oh, you're a nice guy.
Didn't even use it. Fully charged, everything.
In the words of Todd, you're doing a great job.
Almost 70 years.
Oh, yeah. So we didn't find $1 million up there in the ceiling, but we did find this. Your classic S-swing hammer. This looks exactly like my first ever hammer.